So this type of video was very popular for a while, but I chose to upload my video 1 year after a whole chain of channels did. Why did I do such a thing? I don't know. Maybe it's because I'm edgy and I'm thirsty for video ideas. Anyway, growing up, I was a very picky kid. I didn't like things such as Harry Potter, Doctor Who, House of Anubis, without really a reason except for my sister liked it. And I didn't understand it, so I could go die in a hole for all I care. This meant I dodged a lot of things growing up. High School Musical, more like No School Musical. Kim Possible, more like Kim Impossible. Zoe 101, more like Zoe 404. So when it came to her watching things such as Courage the Cowardly Dog, I would just say, nope, I want to sleep tonight. And I would run to the living room complaining to my dad. So yep, I did a pretty good job dodging things that would scare me. But since I was smart enough not to watch Nick at Night, other things had to find their way of scaring me. And that's what I'm here to talk to you guys about. Never thought SpongeBob would be in one of these, did ya? Before you assume that I was only scared of scary SpongeBob fan art, I would have to correct you and tell you that you're wrong. The only time I got scared of SpongeBob fan art wasn't scary fan art, it was weird ones. SpongeBob also scared me as a child with the episodes they aired on TV. I mean, yes, I was a little bit of a wussy back then, still am, but shut up, okay? I have a whole list of SpongeBob episodes that scared me, but I'm not looking to make this video 20 minutes long, so I'm gonna pick from my box of randomly random things that are randomly random for me to pick. Randomly. I know you guys remember this one. For the 1% of people who don't know this episode, it's SpongeBob's turn to be the hall monitor, but he chooses to be an idiot and spends the rest of the day giving a speech. Like an idiot. The start of the episode wasn't even close to scaring me. There was SpongeBob, Patrick, Daylight, Destruction, Daylight. Then the episode tricks me and makes it nighttime. Okay, let me explain a little. Let's go all the way back to 2008, which was probably when I was watching this episode. I was watching this in my big sister's room, alone. And since we've probably just moved there, my big sister didn't have a lamp. So the only source of light was a small 480p, not too bright box TV. You don't really see SpongeBob in the nighttime, and when you do, it's certainly not the focus. Unless if you're talking about a few episodes, but shut up. The episode Graveyard Shift is mostly about the nighttime and how scary it could be. But they cover that up with jokes and their safety over the Krusty Krab. Although, the emptiness of the Krusty Krab can make a little young boy like me cover up with the sheets. Squidward's and SpongeBob's overreacting patched that up for me, so I didn't have to think about how empty my room was. And my soul. The scary vibe from Hall Monitor wasn't covered by anything. You could say Patrick's impression of a police siren covered it, but for me, that only made things worse. Just imagine how I saw this.
Hurry, SpongeBob! I think it's getting dark.
Just put on your siren, I'll be right there.
Okay, I know it didn't go like that, but this is taking too long, so let's go to the next topic. Excuse me, Paulson? Didn't you say that you didn't watch Courage the Cowardly Dog? Oh, well, I didn't watch it. Most of the time, my sister was watching it, and I was basically forced to watch it. Oh, okay, you can go back to talking. I don't remember much from Courage the Cowardly Dog. I was mostly just confused when I watched it.
I didn't know, though, that Courage was the dog, this was the owner that liked Courage, and this is the owner that didn't. Courage the Cowardly Dog was a much more complicated show for me to understand. I'm talking plots, character development, grown-up stuff, three-syllable words. Because of this, I didn't always find Courage the Cowardly Dog scary to me. A lot of the episodes had to do with how scary the story is rather than the visuals. But when the episodes were just like, hey, yo, do you just want to make kids, you know, not sleep? Sure. So then you get episodes like these. One of the only episodes I remember that really scared me was an episode called King Ramsay's Curse. For the 40% of people who don't remember this episode, Eustace gets his hand on an ancient slab owned by this guy, and is too dumb to give it back without getting something in return. The Abomination gets mad and sets three waves of super bad stuff. And that's basically the plot. I mean, it's a good episode, so I won't tell you guys everything, so watch it yourself. If you're not 7 years old or under, you'll probably like it. Everything from the episode is fine, except when it shows King Ramses. Like, I understand. The moral of this story is not to steal ancient treasures stored with dead pharaohs. But you don't need to scar me for that! Okay, before you guys roast me, I would like to state that this happened back in 2012 when I was 9. Currently, I'm 15, so clearly, that was a while ago. On what I consider the golden age of Roblox, there's this game called Bloody Mary. Now, during this golden age of Roblox, there was millions of Bloody Mary games. Bloody Mary was like the Fortnite of Roblox. Now, this game isn't your typical Resident Evil or Silent Hill, it's Roblox. The game did offer somewhat of a story. I mean, I'm sure it's not a good one, but it sure scared me. The story of the game was that everyone was trying the Bloody Mary mirror game because of trends. And you, the main character, was dared to take part in it by your sibling. Once you did it and got out of the bathroom, your sibling was gone with blood everywhere. And apparently, Bloody Mary took them. I don't know how they said Bloody Mary took them, but she did. It was now your job to find your sibling and save them, because 911 operators aren't a thing in this game, because it's Roblox. The game was pretty much you just walking places and talking to people while a bigger story wrapped out. I remember getting really close to finishing the game, but I don't remember saving my sibling. Maybe the game just said congrats and told you to leave, like almost every story game on Roblox. Now you guys might be thinking, wow, Paulson, that's pretty sad. But just you wait, because the story gets even sadder. I don't remember why, but the game led me to do the Bloody Mary game myself. After doing it, I felt pretty strong because nothing happened. When it started to become night, I only got more scared and afraid that something would happen. So by the time I had to go to sleep, I told myself that I wasn't going to sleep for the rest of my life. Also, I wasn't going into a bathroom ever again. But PJs, how did you realize that you were being dumb and that the Bloody Mary game doesn't even exist? And to that, I say, I didn't.